water, also flavoring. Maybe one of you come and help me to dissolve, to add the salt to water. Yes. Kirti Naran is going to add salt. Water and it tries to dissolve. Let you all observe what is going to happen. Substance which dissolves completely in a water, and if it forms a clear solution, is called true solution. Okay, so now this is true solution are also called homogeneous mixtures. These two are homogeneous mixture. Now I will show you the other substance which is there in our campus so much now. You all can play. So now I will be adding this mud to the beaker containing water. which I have given now. We have two solution. We have suspension, isn't it? And it is in the collider solution. Now, the particle size. Observe the particle size. Particles mean the substance we had in, no? Sugar, cooking, containing water. Can you able to say what is the size of particles in this? Because you are not able to see only. Isn't it? So what may be the size? What may be? You are not able to see. That means, the, is it too large or too morbid or too low? Small? The size of the particles is too small to our naked. But we had it, you are sure. This is not plain water. We had it sugar. But particles we are not, it is invisible. We are not able to see. So that means the particle size in fruit solution is too small to observe to our naked eye. Whereas in suspension, can you able to see the particles?
Yes.
That means when compared to fruit solution, the particle size in the suspension or in the heterogeneous solution, what may be the size of the particles in suspension? Compared to fruit solution, you see big or the size is bigger than the fruit solution. Isn't it? If you see this solution which I kept in between, what is the size of the particles here? Yes. It comes in between. Do this particle size. Can you able to see? You can able to see. Is that the particles is big just like suspension?
No.
Is the particle size is small just like invisible in fruit solution?
No.
It is media. Media. So, by keeping in mind the size of the particles, can you able to say what is collide? The same experiment I will be showing now, video clipping. So the size of the particles you can able to observe. You have to think of the size of the particles and you should say what is meant by collide.
Yeah,
Now let it true solution. So this state is called colloidal state or colloidal solution, or is the intermediate state between true solution and suspension. Is it clear? Write down the meaning in the notebook quickly. Meaning of colloid.
Smoke, air, and these are examples of colloid.
Yes. Smoke, yes, air, but the air is also a mixture of different gaseous forms, so it is also a collide. Is it clear with example of collide? Meaning of collide? Yes. Now, you are clear with the meaning of collide and few more examples of collide. This collide, just in the beginning I showed you a picture. Have you seen this kind of things in our day-to-day life? Very big doors, the dark room, like slightly dark. Yes? Yes, what else? Yeah, surface slender. If you open the door, then you can see this kind of effect. Yes? When do you see this kind of effect?
One curtain.
And there is a door. Yeah, if this small window, everything should be closed. If there is a small hole or small opening from the door or from the window, we can able to see that how the rays will be fast, sunrise will be fast. Isn't it? But same thing in dense forest, with the sunrise or in sunset time, we can see some kind of shade formation because of the light, the beam of light passing through the dense things. Isn't it? So these are our examples for effects of collide. This we call it as the properties of collide. Okay, there are different properties of collide. So if you learn properties of collide, you need to say, why do